coup d'etat describes a situation where an existing government is overthrown and replaced, typically in some sort of violent fashion. And so coup is very often used as the shortened version of that coup d'etat to refer to this kind of political upheaval.
So why would there be any question about the how to describe the events in Egypt?
In part because American policy is very careful in what is called a coup and what is, whether a change in the government is called a coup or not. And that's because U.S. foreign aid depends on whether a coup has happened or not. The U.S. law, the Foreign Assistance Act, says that any kind of non-humanitarian aid has to stop if a military coup has happened in the country.
If we go back just a short time in history, 2 years ago to 2011, the popular uprising that ousted longtime Egyptian leader Hosni Mubarak, that was considered a revolution.
Right.
Although the Egyptian military also had a role in that. And so now we also have mass demonstrations on the streets,
Right.
but a more prominent role of the military in this. Is there a hybrid word for
Yeah.
a coup and a popular uprising?
Well, I think people are looking for that kind of term right now. And you could look back at Egypt's history all the way back to 1952, the Egyptian Revolution of 1952, where King Farouk's power was removed in favor of a new system. Again, it was army officers, including Nasser, who became the leader of Egypt, who helped make that happen. So a revolution or an uprising doesn't have to be mutually exclusive from a coup. I mean, sometimes they can go hand in hand. But I think, again, that term coup is so loaded that that a lot of people in Egypt and outside of Egypt say, let's not use that term because it implies that, yes, okay, fine, the military was involved with this. They removed Morsi, the constitution has been suspended, but let's not use that word because it is so loaded and it would imply that the people are not supporting this process.
Do you agree that with the
Oh, well.
military for removing the Muslim Brotherhood?
Actually, I'm not supporter for Morsi at all. But actually, there is another way for solving this problem. You know, after there is a year for President Morsi to control the regime, but we are suffering from a lot of crises. You know, a gas crisis, electricity crisis, everything, unemployment, and he is, you know, he can't solve this problem. So there's a lots of problem
Do you
he can't
think
solve.
so? What do you
But
think, though, of the military removing him from power the way it did?
Actually, I think that they can solve this problem with a conversation with all political powers and especially justice and Justice Party, which Morsi comes from. But it's not. And this wasn't happened. So military ousted Morsi without conversation, without any conversation with him, and it's a fault. But you know, the majority of Egyptians support the military for removing Morsi. You know.
Would you call the military action a coup, or do you think it is a popular uprising against the president?
Okay, it's a coup. You know, it's a coup. It's a really coup. But with Egyptian supporters, if it's a coup without Egyptians supporting, then we're gonna demonstrate against the military. and it's not happened.
Yeah, you don't see what many of people come in the 30th of January and what they can express about their need. They don't need a present hold.
The people are very, like Ardita says, that are very unsatisfied, and kind of expressing their unhappiness is by rebellion, revolution, like going in opposition to the government.
Firstly, people trust the government when they choose them. So when they disappoint of them, when they become disappointed, they do something that they don't want to do. But they do that.
I don't know whether it's okay for them to get rid of the Brotherhood's regime or not. It's a complicated matter, you know, because actually the military, you know, they intervened in this, you know, issue, and that's, I think, against the democracy. But anyway, on the other hand, I think getting rid of the Brotherhood is going to affect the situation here in Libya, because I don't support them at all. But if this is not good, I mean, about the situation there, I mean, the situation there is not stable now, so we can't guess whether it's okay or not. But anyway, if it's okay or not, the military, you know, they have to leave the power, and they have to deliver the government to very good people to take this opportunity, and also to prove themselves. And this will not be good for a lot of people, because one way or another, this is against the democracy. But I can't guess. I'm not sure myself. I don't know.